Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be going over my Hamax Outback bike trailer. I've had this thing for over a year now and I thought it'd be a good time to check in. The things that I love about it, the things that I don't love so much about it, and hopefully help you guys make a decision on whether you want to buy it or not. Let's dive into it. We ride bikes everywhere. That's like what we do in the summer. We need something that is really nice for our kids. We've used Burleys in the past. Burleys are great, but this Hamax is pretty much like the Cadillac of bike trailers with a few trade-offs. It's big and it's heavy. It's wider, longer, and heavier than all the others.
After using it for over a year, I can confidently say that this has been a solid purchase for us. Really depends how much you're really out on bikes, but for people like us, we're nearly out there every day in the summer and we needed something as awesome as this to get our kids and our gear around efficiently. The build has been absolutely great and has been holding up perfectly over this whole past year with no issues or damage at all. It has some really solid tires and wheels with a simple and easy to use quick release that I'll be showing you later on. I can't forget to mention it's a super easy brake pedal they build into it. It comes in really handy when you're parked with the kids. There are two layers that zip into the trailer, a clear window and a screen for letting the wind through. The screen is super high quality. It has been holding up really nicely. Ready for the screen mode, you just simply roll the window up, snap it into place at the top using the buttons. And when you're ready to get the kids out, you could also simply zip up the screen and it leaves the trailer wide open. Screen snaps into place right into the top of the holder as well. The trunk area has a lot of really nice features. It has zippers on the top section that allows you to open the compartment completely, giving you a ton of room, access into where the kids are and where the trunk is as well. To open the storage compartment, you simply zip both zippers down and you'll see how big this compartment is. They give you a ton of room here. You're able to stack bags in here, groceries, whatever you'd like. But yeah, definitely a ton of room. As well as a mesh little holder that goes on the back. You can throw some keys or a wallet in there, or the zipped packet that comes right behind the zip compartment. Both are great spots to hold stuff. The Outback has a really adjustable handle that gives you a ton of different options for it. So to open it, you simply twist it up, and that allows you to adjust it up or down, and it's gonna allow you to lock it into place in any position really. So you can go up really high, you can take it down in the middle, you can get it really low, whatever you'd like.
Assuming that it's a really sunny day, let me show you the full sun shade setup. On the inside of here, there is a sun shade. Now, it comes down and there's these little Velcro pieces. These Velcro goes all the way down, straps in. Now that's going to be the full length sunshade. Let's say it's too far down. You fold it down like that. I just want to get rid of it completely and we tuck it in and it's gone.
Now there's another shade here.
Now you can see sun comes right through there onto their heads, which can be an issue. If we unzip, now if I pull this down, you can see this has Velcro on it just like that too. It's gonna go on, and down. And now we are sealed there. And sealed there. We are sunshade mode. This is also the place where the arm will attach to the bike. This comes with the kit. It is the stroller wheel. In order to take this off, you see here we have a green go symbol there. That means you're ready to go. It means it's locked in. If we go up to red, you see it turns red. This means it's unlocked. And if we press this button right here and pull, you'll see that come out. A little wet from my washing session. If you want to put this back on, just make sure we are on the green go. Here's the piece that goes onto the bike. You can see it's the same attachment that goes on here. We are going to go to red, out, pull, and then we're going to take this, and this just goes right in here like that, down. We are ready to go. This is the attachment piece that goes on the bike. It's just a little bolt that bolts it onto your frame. Once you actually get that on, you can see here, that's all you need. And you're able to attach that right to your bike. And you'll see this piece right there, and it just essentially goes right on. We've got a pin here, and this pin goes down, and then it grips under the bottom and it clips just like that. And what you're gonna do with this piece is you wanna wrap it around, get that hooked up to this little thing right here, just like that. If it ever falls off or has a problem, it'll stay attached to the bike.
We are all set.
If you wanna go in bike mode, a little bit more sleek, pull that down, locked up, and we're ready. And then if you get it right, it does that, and then you're down. Say we're out of the car and we're ready to put it back together. Holding it back up. What you do is you lift, lift, and you pull, and you're good. See that? Don't forget to please like this video and subscribe if you find this helpful. All right, one thing that the Hamax has is shocks. The suspension is adjustable. Here's where you actually adjust it. All you do is twist. Now this way, we're tightening it, is all the way tight. So the tightest suspension, the shortest suspension. If you go all the way out like this, this will give you the cushiest, most suspension. That's where I leave it for the most part. Not only is it one of the sickest bike trailers, it is the best stroller too. But along with that comes the heaviness of it, the weight, the size of it. It's definitely like the biggest child stroller you'll ever use. It barely fits through some doors. Bringing it through a mall where there's a lot of space, it's totally killer. I would recommend it all the time for, you know, if you're at like a state fair or something and you're pushing around all day, use this thing.
As far as cruising around with it has been a total blast. I've been loving our rides with it. It's a little bit heavy, but we have a little electric bike that'll assist with it and make it a little bit easier. But other than that, everything is awesome about it. And our rides are seriously so much more fun.
Let's assume we are ready to pack this thing up, take it somewhere else. So what we're gonna do is unhook it from the bike. It's gonna come off. Now we're unhooked. Next step is we're gonna get this off. These wheels are the best. Get this wheel off, there's a button. And that's all you need to do. What you're gonna do is you're gonna pick it up a little bit, pull it off, press this button, and pull. There you go. To put it back in, you're just going to use that. You're gonna press the button, hold the button. It goes back in, and let go. And you're locked. That one out. Now we got our wheels. So our wheels are gonna put to the side, which you'll see. So, first step is to loosen this. Keep it loose, and then you'll see here, and grab this. That's your strap, that's your, and this is tricky. So, it took me a while to get this at first, but what you're gonna do is press both buttons, then pull. So this unlocks these. You gotta do them both at the same time. And then if you get it right, it does that. You can see it pull all the way, and then you're down. In a car, and it's pretty thin. Let's say we're out of the car and we're ready to put it back together. What you do is you lift, lift, and you pull, and you're good. See that? Compared to like these other strollers that are really tight, the whole purpose of this is to give a ton of padding, a ton of room, and then look at this foot room. These guys have a ton of space to stretch out their legs. The padding, it's well built. There's no issues with it. There's nice pockets in the inside. These windows are nice. These are some nice vents up here too. So you have vents, air vents for them. When everything's shut, they'll still be able to get that. So I pulled out my old Burley to show you a comparison here. And this is an old Burley, so they might be different. It's really old. You can see the width there. And then you can see the wheelbase on this one. Got an extra couple inches. See how it's tight on the Burley? The Hamax brand, they just don't sacrifice their comfort, you know, for portability in some situations. Everything, how it's set up compared to that, I mean, it's night and day. This seat, it looks pretty far forward. So what you're actually able to do here, push these both inside and start twisting. See how I'm rolling the bar down? Look at how far that goes. They've got a nice recline.
bench.
Hopefully that helps you guys make a better decision of which one you want to get. There are cheaper ones than this. This is a very high level one, so you don't feel comfortable. Look at the Burley brands. Look at a few of the other Amazon brands if you just want to get started. There's a lot of different options out there. Thanks guys. See you in the next one. Peace.